Welcome to today's edition of 3 Minute Halakha. What happens if you're eating Sudash Lishit and it's Erev Rosh Chodesh? What do you say in benching? Do you say Ritzei because it was Sudash Lishit, it was Shabbos? Or do you say Ya'alev Yavo because it's already after sunset and really the next day and it's Rosh Chodesh? Or should you say both? The Rosh rules that ultimately when you bench, the additions you add into benching are determined by the time frame of your benching. Therefore, you're benching and it's after sunset, he would say you recite Ya'alev Yavo exclusively. The Maharam is understood by the Bach and the Aruch HaShulchan disagrees. And he is of the opinion that the text of benching follows when the meal began. According to the Maharam, you would only say Ritzei. However, the Taz understands the Maharam differently and views the possibility that how you bench is determined either by when the meal began or when you're benching. According to the Taz, you would actually say both Ya'alev Yavo and Ritzei in your benching. The Taz himself explains that this is not a problem, Siman Kuf Pechet Sivkat Anzayim, because ultimately you first say Ritzei, as if it was Shabbos, and only afterwards you say Ya'alev Yavo, as if it was Rosh Chodesh. However, the overwhelming majority of poskim disagree and say it has to be one or the other, and it can't be both. And therefore, the Magen Avraham says that we should follow the Rosh's position, that with the time frame you're davening in should be what determines what you say, and we would recite only Ya'alev Yavo, unless you didn't eat any bread after sunset. Then you would still be able to say Ritzei. The Mishnah Berurah ultimately follows the position of the Magen Avraham. The Aruch HaShulchan, on the other hand, follows the position of the Maharam, that it goes after the beginning of the meal. What should we do? Rav Lichtenstein was of the opinion that when you were eating Sudash Lishit and it was Erev Rosh Chodesh, that you should always try to bench before Shkia to avoid any problem whatsoever. You could continue singing afterwards, but end by sunset. Whereas Rav Amital felt it was a different possibility, and that was to take the position of the Magen Avraham, that not to eat any bread after sunset, but continue the meal. In that way, even according to the Magen Avraham, you'd be able to recite Ritzei. There are a number of options, the Aruch HaShulchan or the Magen Avraham. Both are correct, and both are positions that people assume.